Hi, I'm David Gibson, and I'm here, virtually here, with Yaki Faitelson, CEO of Varonis, and we want to talk today a little bit about cloud and SaaS security. So Yaki, we've heard a lot about digital transformation and the adoption of cloud and SaaS over the past year or so. How are these new data stores affecting the way people think about security and data protection?
You know, David, everything that happened with COVID just accelerated digital transformation. What is happening is that data protection around these data repositories and application, it's just a huge issue. It's very hard to understand what data is critical, where users can access, and how to remediate access control to make sure that the users can only access what they need to access in this ever-changing environment. If you will ask today any CISO, it's just very hard to visualize who can access the data, to understand what service account and APIs are doing, to tell if there is any abnormal behavior, much harder to manage the interconnectivity between these systems.
A lot of these blind spots remind me of what we see with on-prem file systems, right?
Many of these SaaS repositories are very similar to file system from the access control needs. Think about G Drive and Box and Salesforce.com. And if you take a random user from his chair, between 50 to 90% of the data that they can access, it's not relevant for them.
Yep.
So this really profound problem in data protection opening a massive attack surface.
And we've seen that the larger the attack surface gets, the harder it becomes to spot threats, especially when the environment is so dynamic.
You know, these are internet-facing systems. With all these rapid releases and the system-wide configuration, when you're using them in the wrong way, they can open all the systems and the administrators are really not aware. And there is no reliable way to alert on abnormal behavior and configuration changes. Because of the connectivity between SaaS applications, it's very easy to move from one to the other and inflict tremendous damage and take a lot of critical information from organizations in places that they are completely blind. The other thing that is happening is that cryptocurrency becoming much more prevalent, and it's easier to monetize cybersecurity crimes.
So with a growing complex and vulnerable attack surface, as well as motivated attackers, what should organizations do? Where should they start to protect themselves?
If you really think about it, data protection and cybersecurity collided. The capacity to create and share data exceeded drastically the capacity to protect it. All the security vectors that the organization has, by and large, they are there in order to protect data. It's much more practical and much more efficient to start with the data.
Yeah.
What we call the inside-out approach: protect your data, make sure that only the right people can access the right data, to understand what is sensitive, what fields are sensitive, what chats are sensitive, what documents are sensitive. Make sure that you can visualize the risk. You need to make sure that you can remediate it, and then that you have alerts on any abnormal behavior. Once you can do that, you really reduce drastically the risk of your organization, and you need to do it across clouds. If you will do that, you solved most of the problem.
Thank you so much, Yaki, and thank you everyone for tuning in. We'll see you again soon.